What's up, guys? DJ Woo Pig. Today, you get a tour of the trailer.
Hey guys, you know who it is. Back today with a view of what I got in my trailer. It's hot out here. I was going to do this the other day, but it was too damn hot. Now it's just kind of hot. Down to 90, 95, 96 degrees today. We had a little, as we call it, summer cold front come through. Took it down from 102 to 95, which is, I mean, in comparison, big difference. So, yeah, I'm just going to give you a tour of what I've got in my trailer. Keep in mind, this isn't all my gear. This is, I would say about 80% of it. Right now, I've got some speakers rented out to a buddy, and then I've got another set of speakers at my church. The Yorkvilles are at the church. I use those as drum monitors because sometimes I play drums at church. A little tidbit: I went to school on a drum scholarship. I'm actually an accomplished musician, I guess you would say. Good enough to go to college for nothing. Well, I wouldn't say nothing. I still had to pay something, but you get my drift. So the Yorkvilles are at the church. What do I have rented out to? Let's see. I've got the EV ZX5s. I know we got some EV haters, but those ZX5s are no slouch. They're not the ETX punks or whatever you call them. ETX still sound good. I'm an EV guy. I like EV. I like JBL. I like, you know, whatever gets the job done. But the EV or the Electro Voice ZX5s are my go-to speaker. So keep in mind, I've got those rented out. So let's just kind of give you a what else do I have not here? EV QRX 12s. They're not here. They're at my buddy Jeremy. My buddy Jeremy owns a live sound production company, like big festivals, stuff like that. And I keep some of my stuff at his shop because I just don't have enough room for it in this trailer. So the big stuff, the dual 12s, I keep at his shop because he uses them too. It kind of works back and forth. Whenever I have something big like a school prom that I need to rent something from him, I just go grab his stuff and I keep some of my stuff there. I've got some truss there that I keep at his shop that he uses for totems and stuff like that. Festival, he does a lot of festival works, small concert, you know, nothing arena, I'd say more stadium style events. But yeah, so I've got some speakers rented out. I've got some truss rented out. But for the most part, this is the bulk of my gear. That I keep in my trailer all time, 24/7, no matter what. I hook up and I'm ready to go. Minus I would say the ZX5s, because those stay here quite a bit. They're just not here right now. But anywho, I'll give you a tour of my trailer and a tour of my truck. The truck isn't anything special, but you get the drift.
All right, guys, that is my truck. It is a 99 model GMC Yukon four-wheel drive 5.7 liter motor. It's nothing special, but it gets the job done. I've put a set of 22s on the wheels and tires. They do pretty good with the trailer and everything. But yeah, it pulls fine. It looks decent. I mean, it's not a Benz or anything, but for what I got, it looks pretty good. And there's my trailer. It is a 6x12. I just got this one at the first of the year, so it's a 2015 model, brand spanking new, 6x12 dual axle, tandem axle, as they say. Trailer. It's got electric brakes on it, diamond plate in the front as a rock guard. Let's walk around here to the back. It's got the folding back door. Might want to hide that license plate, but folding back door, and then on the side it's got a side door for access on the side. So
first things first, I opened the trailer door, and I did not look inside the trailer this past weekend whenever I had an event. I parked the trailer and didn't realize I had a little spill, maybe hit a bump, maybe hit a curb a little too hard, and found some stuff in the floor.
Is why you always need to have your gear in some sort of case. And I've been meaning, these are my American DJ Mega Tripod profiles. I've got some of the RGB RCs and then the Ultra Bars back there. I've been meaning to get cases for this, and this is just going to make me go out and buy a case, because now I've got to go through and test all these and make sure they didn't take too much damage, and then assess the damage and replace whatever's broken. Hopefully nothing's broken, but this is just point in case of why you need a case to protect your
investment. You can see from the back that my stuff took a spill, and immediately I noticed that there's no strap there, and that's because I got in a rush wanting to get home from the last gig, and what do you know, that strap is still hanging up there. I never even tied it down, so that is on me. That's my bad, guys. Take your time, otherwise you have shit like this happen, and there might be, you know, I might pay the price on this. I might be out of pocket a couple $100 trying to get stuff fixed and replaced. So lesson to the wise: when always breaking down, it's always good to be in a rush to get out of there, but take your time and do it right, because you'll end up paying for it, like I'm probably gonna
start off with lighting. In this case here, I've got 10 Chinese RGBAW wireless DMX fixtures. There's 10 of them there, and I bought this big old Husky case. You can get them at hardware stores like Lowe's. I bought this one at Home Depot for cheap. So this case here, this big Husky case, I can set it down. It's got wheels on the end of it. It's also got a pull-out handle there on the end that I can wheel it in with. I bought this case here for $80, and with a little bit of customization, I'm gonna stick a floor in there and buy 10 more of these parts, because they've worked out good. That was my first time buying Chinese fixtures, and it's hot, guys. That was my first time buying Chinese fixtures, so I bought 10 of them just to kind of see the bang for the buck. Some people have had good luck, some people haven't had good luck. With these, I've had, you know, it's been fine. So I'm going to end up buying 10 more of these, so I'll have a total of 20 in this case. I'm probably going to make that purchase here, I'd probably say in the next 2 months or so, probably right when school dance season starts picking up. That's when I'll go ahead and buy 10 more of these. So I've got 10 of those in this box here, and then I'm going to make an additional purchase and get 10, so I'll have 20 of these all together. So that's my PAR box for wireless LED uplights. Got the charging cords there. Another thing I like about this is I can daisy chain these together, and then this here is divots cut out for sticking cable through, so I can charge them in that box, never have to take them out of that box again. So there's one PAR trunk, and this one here, that's the one that fell out on the ground, and of course it's got two Ultra Bars, two Mega Bar 50 RGBs, we've got Mega Tris as the rest of it. So all together, PAR wise, LED PAR wise, I've got 20 at least RGB fixtures. I've got, of the Mega Tripar profile, I've got 6 more of those on their way. They should be here probably today or tomorrow. And then I'm going to have to buy a case, because that really pisses me off. I just wasn't even thinking. And as you saw, it was all over the floor. So PARs all together. I do a lot of school events, a lot of corporate events too. I want at least 40 PARs, 40 LED PARs, and then I'm going to stop. But I'm not going to stop buying until I get to 40. So I like to, you know, save up, put some money back, buy 2 here, 2 here, 6 here, you know, just build up your stash. So here is another trunk. This has got 2 Chave Q spots inside of it. They are 375-watt bulb discharge moving head. I'm not going to take it out because they are a bitch to get back in there, but I do have one up here in the front, sitting on the floor. These are good. I actually bought these out of the club I work in regularly, about twice a month I'm there. But as you can hear, that one there's got a lot of noise. So I don't use it much except for on school dances when nobody's gonna hear it anyway. I don't use them at weddings. I've got the best two in this case here. Those are Chave Q-Spot discharge pin spotting. I've got the Chave Easy Pin pin spot pack. Pretty much bought this all in a kit. It all comes in this nice little carrying case. They all plug into this main charging dock, main cable there. 6 pin spots, never had to use more than 6, so this is sufficient enough
for what I do.
Standing up right there, I'm not going to bring it out because once you see one PAR system, you've seen them all. This is the American DJ Dots T-PAR system. I am going to say that I have been very, very impressed with the T-PAR system. It can really flood out a room with little effort and have plenty of light. Comes with a foot controller switch, can run DMX. It has chip on board LEDs, which is pretty dope. They're super bright, super efficient, and I like it a lot. I'm probably going to end up buying another one of those for bigger rooms where you want a lot more coverage, but you don't want to set up, you know, a lot of stands and put PARs on it individually. Probably going to buy another one of those maybe in a couple months. We'll just have to see.
In this bag here is my American DJ Icon LED. I bought this bag here at Harbor Freight. If you don't have a Harbor Freight near you, man, you need to take a trip. They've got a lot of cheap bags, cases, some of the cases I have in here, that case right there, those two back there, I bought from Harbor Freight. Super affordable cases, bags, tools, odd ends, just random ass shit, really. You go in there, you're gonna buy something. So in this bag, I've got that with gobos down there at the bottom, power cable, lenses, remote, pretty much everything I need for gobo projection is in that bag.
Right in that bag there, and the other bag up top, I have these bad boys, Martin MX-1 scanners. I know a lot of you guys have seen Brandon Stewart. He has the MX-10s. They are a lot more badass than the MX-1s, but they're super, super high. They don't make them anymore. They're discontinued. But for scanners, these things are solid. The motors are just as silky smooth as moving heads. So I use these a lot for school dances. I've got two of them. So on my school dance truss, non-prom. Prom, I do a lot of renting. I rent a lot of stuff to, you know, I don't need it, so I don't buy it. I just rent it. But for dances, homecoming dances, junior high, stuff like that, I'll use four moving heads, and these two scanners does a great job. So Martin MX-1, I've got two of those. On to the next one.
So packed up there, you see all the lighting. We got the wireless, the movers, the wired PARs. If you notice, all the wire, all the lighting is on the back end of the trailer, simply because I do a lot of lighting. So lighting goes out first, put it on the ass end of the trailer. I do a lot more, really, I do a lot of lighting jobs without even doing sound for corporate events and stuff like that. So it goes on last just because it's the last thing, first thing you can pull off, you know. Go ahead and get it out of your way, get it set up, get it done, and boom. So next thing we've got is sound. We'll start doing some sound stuff.
So as you can see, I've got two seismic audio boxes. With Eminence loaded 15. Those are non-powered. They are passive. The ones in the middle, there's one there and there's one behind there. Those are Seismic Audio powered 12s. They are loaded with Eminence drivers inside of them. These two speakers here are the only powered speakers I have. I come from a live sound background, so just about all the sound equipment I have is passive. You got to run a separate amp just because that's the way I like it, damn it. I've not to say that I'm a passive guy or that I'm a, you know, I am a passive guy actually, but I don't, you know, it's all in personal preference. I just prefer to go passive. That's how I've always done it. I like amps and EQs and crossovers, and I don't, you know, the more stuff you build in, I feel like you lose a lot more control over it, which is why I run passive equipment. So, yeah. So anyway, down there, there's two speakers there. Normally, I don't take these with me. Normally, that's where my ZX5 Eevees go, but they're in here, so there they are. Two 12s in the middle. Backing it up. Right here, we have four. I've got two on each side. These two just have wheels on them. These are PV-118 subs. They are loaded with PV Black Widow drivers. Probably the best bang for your buck sub as far as output, the abuse it can take, total package, is a PV Black Widow.
And this, of course, is if you're going passive. I know a lot of you guys are running QSC rigs, nothing against, you know, you guys. But I like these. They sound good. They don't look bad. Probably when it gets a little cooler, I use these two the most because they've got wheels on it. Whenever I do school dances, I stack these two on top of those two and then put my QRXs on top of those. So we've got a three speaker stack setup, but probably when it gets a little cooler, I'm going to put some Duratex on these. It really livens it up, makes it look a lot newer. Take this old carpet off. As you can see in this hot trailer, this stuff has started to peel. So it's a good thing because I don't use these a lot anyway. So those are my subs. I'm not going to pull these dudes out, but these are dual 15 Madison cabinets. Madison is a live sound company that went out of business. They got bought out by... I want to say they got bought out by JBL, Harman Kardon Crown, the big company. They were out of Madison, Wisconsin. Madison. But I have Eminence 15-inch drivers in those. I use these a lot for school dances if I don't use the QRXs. If I feel like it's a big room and they need a little bit more low end, I'll use these instead of using the QRX dual 12s. So let me go ahead and turn this camera around. That wraps up sound equipment. We got four subs, two dual 15s. I've got two dual 12 QRXs, which aren't here. And guys, QRXs, I know if Jay Mathis sees this, he is a QSC guy through and through. Go listen, go look at some of the reviews on the QRXs and get back to me. That's all I gotta say. That's all the trash I'm talking. The QRX12s, which aren't here, ZX5As, which aren't here, or ZX5s, the A's are the active. I don't do active, as we already said. ZX5s, which aren't here, two 15 Eminence, two 12 Eminence, and the powered seismic audio boxes, the amps in them, they're not terrible. I just didn't like how the driver sounded. So pretty much any rental gear I get cheap boxes, load them with a good driver, and make your money back on your investment. So I really like the company Eminence. As you can see, I'm pumping their name a lot. Check into their stuff. If you ever blow any speakers, any horns, stuff like that, give them a look because the price is comparable. It's a good price and you get great equipment for the price. So that's what a lot of the sound companies around here use, is Eminence stuff. So that's just what I've went with. So moving on, I've got cases and trunks.
These are the four main cases or trunks that I use for hauling cable, cords, whatever. This one down here houses speaker cable from going from the amp to the speaker. That one there houses power cable, all black extension cable, period. That one there houses mic cable, DMX cable, and any other audio cable that's non-speaker. This one here houses a whole bunch of nothing. It houses, what are those called? IECs, like that go on the back of your speakers or go on the back of your lights, mixer. A lot of this stuff takes IEC cable, so I've got a trunk dedicated to it. A lot of times it stays in the trailer. I just use it if I have to.
Up this case right here, it's got a mixer in it. Yeah, it's got a Behringer mixer, which is what I use to go from my controller to the mixer to the amp. Then we've got wireless microphones here. These are GT Audio. They are Shure clones, and by clones, I mean they did a damn good job. If you've ever seen the Shure SM58s, these are identical. They sound great. They're a great price. Highly recommend these mics. I really got into these before anybody else did. Now, if you look on the Facebook forums, these are super popular. Highly recommend those. Behind the trunks here, we've got my table. As you can see, I've taken a hole saw and cut through the table because I've got a fitted tablecloth, and I've cut holes in that tablecloth and took it to an upholstery shop and had them seam those holes up to where it's not frayed. That way I can, if I don't want to use my facade, I can tuck those cables through the table for a nice, clean, professional look. Behind that, I have my facade. It's in a padded case. I've also got a tabletop facade here that I built
It's held up pretty good, but if I had to do it all over again, I would just buy one like I did with that one. After a while, you can probably see it. It just starts getting beat the hell up. So I use that for tabletop. If I don't have the room or want to do the full facade, I use my tabletop facade here and use my stand-up normal facade the rest of the times. That corner's kind of boring. Speaker stands, mic stands, all that stuff goes in this corner here. Those are crank stands for my truss, which I use for school dances. They are the DuraTruss 3800L crank stands. They can hold a lot of weight. They're kind of heavy themselves. I use those a lot for putting truss in the air when I do school dances. Good, great crank stands for the money. DuraTruss, which is a parent company of Global Truss, American DJ, all that stuff. Good product, good value. So yeah, those are pretty good stands. Moving right along here, open this box up. This is ammo cases work great for truss parts. And if you've ever seen a sound company, production company, Live Sound, that's what they use, ammo boxes, which is where I got that idea from. But I've got all my pins for my truss, ball peen, hammer. I keep the manual in there just in case I got a new guy rolling out with me. He can read up on that. Big carabiners for rigging to ceilings, and so on and so forth. This idea I actually stole from Mr. Jay Mathis. This is all my my wireless DMX stuff. I'll take these off the top, and then underneath it I've got my my wireless sticks. I've got four receivers, one transmitter, Show Express box. I'm not seeing my Show Express wire, but it's around here somewhere. So that's my wireless DMX. Forgot to mention something. These shelves here didn't come in there, but I feel like it is a must. If you've got a V-nose or a curved nose trailer, take advantage of that room. As you can see, this just kind of be hectic if I didn't have a place to put it. So I had my buddy build these. I have a lot of things, and I wear a lot of hats, but one thing I am not is a carpenter, so I had my buddy build that, traded him out for some cold beer. Worked out pretty good on my end, I think. All right, we've got two sticks of truss. I've got two in here. I've got four altogether of the 7 meters or 6.56 meter sticks. I've got two in here because a lot of times I just use two totems. So why have them in here taking up room? The other two I've got at my buddy Jeremy's house, or at his shop. He's the guy that owns the sound company. So I just keep them there. He uses them, whatever. We trade stuff out, so it works out good because I really don't have the room for it. You buy a trailer, you think you're not going to ever fill it up. And as you can see, I have quite a bit of stuff, but I don't have that much stuff. And this dude's already full. So I take with me all the essentials, and then the other stuff, I don't mind leaving.
So we've covered speakers, we've covered truss, we've covered lighting, cables, trunks, mixers, stuff like that. Now we have my amp rack. Let me spin the camera.
This is the main amp rack that I use, I would say, I'd probably say 70% of my gigs. This little guy right here is what I use. It houses Behringer EPX 2800 2000 watt amplifier. Great amplifier for the price. Puts out a lot of good sound coming out of this guy. Also, I like that it's got a built-in crossover, so you can switch frequencies if you're running a sub amp or a sub main combo. But a lot of times I use this, I'm just using mains. Those ZX5s put out plenty of bass for small venues. I don't necessarily need it. DOD graphic equalizer, the GTD audio wireless microphone transmitter. That screws a little loose. I need to tighten that back up. And then up top, let me move that out of the way. Up top, we've got a Furman M8DX power conditioner. It's got the digital LED readout of voltage display on top. So amp,
or EQ, you always, and that's the thing, guys, if y'all ever start running passive systems, and really if you're running active systems, I would always recommend a dedicated EQ, especially if you're using any sort of microphone, especially lapel microphones, because they give you a tough time. It's a tough time balancing out lapel microphones next to speakers. You don't always have the best speaker placement, so I would always recommend a dedicated EQ. This DOD here, this is about 10 years old, maybe more. Still a great piece of equipment. Would not leave home without it. All right, and this right here is my big amp rack. Down at the bottom, EP 4000, Behringer 4000 watt amp, usually using this to drive subs. On top of it, Crown XLS 1000. It's got a built-in crossover digital display, mostly for mains, or I can cross them over and use subs if I have to. Above it is Behringer Super X Pro crossover for crossing over subs. Above it, OSP compressor. Right here, empty slot, is where EQ goes. I had my KT Clark Technic EQ go out. So it is back at the factory getting fixed, and it'll be back in shortly. Empty space for the Clark Technic EQ, another wireless GTD audio lapel mic system. Another blank space, this one actually it held a, what was in there? I forgot what was in there, but I'm building a patch panel so I can just have quick disconnects on the front of the amp rack instead of having to dig into the back. That's what that empty space is going to be utilized for. And then above it, we have a another Furman power conditioner. So power conditioner, there's a blank right there. I'm going to use this whole thing for my patch panel. Wireless microphone systems, Clark Technic EQ normally goes here, it's at the shop, OSP compressor, Behringer crossover, Crown amplifier, and Behringer. So that is pretty much it. That wraps up the trailer tour for now. Sorry if it felt a little bit rushed, because I was rushing, really. I said we're going through a little cold spell here in Arkansas because it's only 95 degrees. It's still hot as hell in that trailer, black trailer with metal walls. It's still hot, so I was trying to rush through without sweating too bad. But if you're wanting any more, you know, if you want more detail into how something works or what I got, just let me know and I'll shoot a video on it individually. Coming up hopefully this weekend sometime, I'll be posting a video on hooking up a passive audio system. Bobby Blends, shout out to Bobby Blends watching the video, thumbs up. Thanks, Bobby. He wanted to know a little bit more about hooking up a passive audio system. That is something that I do primarily. So I'll be showing y'all kind of what I do, the steps to go through hooking up a passive system. So also not in this trailer shown is my Pioneer DDJ SX2. I keep it at the house because you got to practice. So that's at the house. My computers and stuff are at the house. I'm trying to think if I have anything else at the house. I don't think so. So we were missing a few things today. Not very much. Y'all pretty much got the gist of what I'm working with. So if you have any questions, comments, all that stuff, leave it in the comment section down below. If you want to know something more in depth, like setting EQs and stuff like that, just let me know and I'll shoot a video on it individually. So until next time, it's DJ Woo Pig, y'all. Try to stay cool. Later.